Hey there, this is Game Hoard Game, and as the title screen says, this is Satellite Rain. Let's get logged in here. We're playing under Poob, not Poob the Destroyer. I have done a little bit of this game on my own time, but that was months ago, and there's been some updates since then, etc., etc. Basically, I'm still mostly blind in this game. Essentially, and what I have seen, it's been long enough that I've all but forgotten. Yeah, that's all there is to it. But we got some fun stuff to do this time. Last time we managed to free our infiltrator. So, that means that now we've got our whole team together. That's pretty good. The infiltrator has some skills and abilities. I don't think we get too much of them yet. However, we do have him with a sniper rifle, which is useful in itself. So let's go ahead and pull our guys out here. Okay, I guess before we do too much, what we want to do is go to research. So we've got a CR-12 assault rifle. What does this say? Increased accuracy, damage, and range. The Lincoln Ballistic CR-12 assault rifle is a true star. Probably accounts for why it's one of the most popular black market weapons. Firing shorter bursts to maintain accuracy, the CR-12 assault rifle is the weapon of choice for any medium to long-range shooter. Wonder how that compares to our actual, like, regular one. Start research. Okay, so I guess we could assign this to one of our soldiers, but let's hit research. Currently don't have much in the way of company funds. It would probably be best to pause this research for now and resume it once we have knocked over the bank or installed some ATM siphons around the city. Okay, so that's just showing me that I can research it, but we'll pause. Okay, so cost remaining, 5,000 for the pistol and a little bit more for the rifle. So I guess we're not going to be able to do a whole lot with that yet. Okay, it's pointing me towards Satellite Project Rain, and find a researcher. For logistics and tech support, we're going to need some researchers of our own. We'd get a great start on our own little tech division, except for the chief I've got in mind works for another corp. The good news is, we know he's unhappy there, and any decent bribe will get him out. Whew, Mr. Obersky's moving up in the world. Looks like he owns a place at the Tomset Towers apartment. Okay. These apartments are pretty expensive, even for the Golden Mile. It should be a piece of cake to find him here. Once there, use your support agent's world scan ability to run facial recognition protocols to pinpoint the researcher. After identifying him, pay him, and we'll automatically get him started on any active research projects we have running. Okay, we'll activate the ping on him. So he is over in the north side, nestled between these two military compounds. Okay, back. What else we got? Find fresh clones. Alright, so this is what it was pointing us to do outside of our research. So, cool, our new research friend says the cloning bays are back online. Clones allow replacement bodies for our agents, a somewhat brutal but necessary act if we are to succeed. Yeah, we fucking snatch people's bodies, man. It's pretty fucking crazy. Once you've scanned as a civilian, you can select them. Sorry, just one sec. Yeah, I've been sick recently and it's murdering my voice. So, anyway, once you've scanned a civilian, you can select them and divert a small amount of resources to obtain a deeper scan, giving you info on their DNA traits. Once you have a target, use your hacker to hijack them and send them back for cloning. Your clones will degrade after each cloning procedure, so you'll need to acquire fresh resources to keep your agents at their peak, or just keep your agents alive. The markets are full of potential targets. Okay. That, like, really, there's some really goddamn questionable ethics going on. So, let's see here. There's this guy who's wearing, like, the giant neck protector. Let's hit up the world scan here. Hey, you. Look, just move over a bit. Let's see. Hijack costs 6%, 16% of energy regen. Oh, so I can hijack people and make them do crazy shit, or I can send them back for cloning. So let's purchase some extra info. This is Miss Lola McBride, female, and she has increased health regeneration by 0.15 a second, increased speed by 2%, and increased health by 10. Alright. We really do not want to mind fuck her at the moment, though. Because there's soldiers nearby and they're gonna watch us. I'm pretty sure they look down. Okay, this person has 2% speed and 20 extra health. Alright, so now we use this guy's mind fuck ability. Come here, we're gonna hijack your mind. Don't turn around, soldiers. Everything is fine here. Everything is cool. No problem at all. Don't you look over here. Okay, see, now he becomes like our fifth unit, right? So we have different abilities on him. So we can return him for cloning, unhijack, so basically set him free, or show his info. So that just brings up the panel that shows everything about him. So, like, right now, his hijacked is costing our hacker 15% of his energy regen, but that's just because we're holding him as a hacked guy rather than sending him back for cloning. So we're going to return him for cloning. Old Kirk Christensen returned for cloning. Okay, so, wait, does that guy count as returned yet? Or does he have to, like, fuck off for a little while first? Because this is him right there. He's running away, but... And we'll probably be able to see where he goes since he's hijacked at the moment, but maybe not. Okay, he's gone. So, now, we'll open up our options menu. And I think if we go to loadout, yeah, here's where we start being able to fool around with this, the cloning screen. This screen lets you change each agent's clone and customize their appearance. Clones come with small varying bonuses for your agent, but be warned, the cloning process is not perfect, and each time you clone someone, their bonuses will degrade. So, this character that we're on, though, the Sienna Cloudstepper, has no bonuses whatsoever associated with her. So, if we select this clone... Now, see, this is our hacker in this person's body, which is kind of neat. So, you can actually, like... The source, so that's what the guy was wearing on his head. That's what source means. None just means, you know, the basic. And then default, he puts on the hacker gear. So, apply the currently selected clone. So, we're going to get a plus 20 health bonus, 2% to our speed, and 0.1 health regeneration on top of what we already have. So, we'll hit apply. And we can just go ahead and set Sienna Cloudstepper free, I believe. Yeah. You sure you want to dispose of her? Yeah, just delete her, please. Thank you. Alright. So, he looks like a fucking badass like that, though. Wait, okay, hacker, infiltrator, support, and Coloma. Okay, so, I don't understand. Okay, so I'm on the hacker at the moment, so whichever one of these I highlight, I could switch my hacker into my soldier's body, I think. Hey, is Coloma, I thought Q Coloma was way bigger than that. Oh, that's if the hacker takes over the body. I see, if... No. So if we have... Okay, so now we'll see all these people in the huge... Because, okay, the soldier must get, like, a big-ass suit. Man, these people look fucking crazy like that. Alright. Now, you know what? What can I do with this? Oh, okay, I can actually change some of their, setups, though. Color. Company. I really wish I could, differentiate them... between each other, but wait, okay, I think I was misclicking when I was doing this before, so if I hit apply, nope, everybody turned blue. I don't want everybody to be blue. That's kind of annoying, but I don't know. I guess we all have to stay color coordinated. It's the future, it's important. Do we have any skills going on? Alright, who is this? This is our support guy. So we can increase world scan. Field medic. Support agent gives the entire team bonuses in both health and health regeneration. The skill also enhances the effectiveness of medkit heal ability for the support agent and gives an extra health regeneration ability to the support agent. That seems pretty good. What's team stims? Distributes stimulants to the team, enhances senses and reflexes for a short time. This allows the agents to feel as if time is moving much slower. Wow, that's actually really cool. Leadership. Support agent is linked into the neural implants of each of your agents. This allows the support agent to better coordinate the team, improving their ability usage. Increase cooldown speed by 4% for all agents. Increase energy regen speed by 5%. Jeez, that seems pretty good. And max energy is increased by 8. I think what I'm going to do off of the start is field medic. I feel like field medic is going to come in really handy. There we go. Okay, that's all skilled out. And let's see. Oh yeah, now that we've got our infiltrator, we can also assign the rifles and stuff. Now, I thought I could use... Yeah, look, I can assign my prototype pistol to these people too. So if I go to the soldier, instead of the Uzi, shouldn't I be able to assign... Okay, no, it's the laser pistol. I thought I was able... Oh, it's because I activated the research on that rifle. That's what made it not available anymore. So I'll need to complete the research before I can make it available. Not that big a deal. I'm not going to worry about the weapon upgrades too hard right now. So our soldier clone has been applied. Let's find our crew. Okay, no, our soldier's the same, but our hacker has changed. I like his armor. Alright guys, look, we got our infiltrator basically looks like the Assassin's Creed guy. Yeah, let's pull him over here for a sec. Look, I don't like the way this guy's looking at me, you know? We could just, like, slaughter him real quickly, and nobody... I don't think there's anybody over here who could help. You know? Bang, 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 bang! You're dead! I just happened to kill a civilian in the meantime, but it's not my fault. Nobody look at me. Nope, don't look over here. Ooh, there's a camera there. I didn't even realize that. Yeah, you guys are... They're coming over there to check it out, but we're going to be long gone. So we're still suspicious, I think. Yeah, we're alerted to the authorities, so let's just keep ourselves away from there for a second. All right, guys, take cover. Look, you got to fucking calm down, dude. Shit, is that guy going to go tell on me? Is that Raiden? Raiden, don't give up. Don't give me up to the authorities, please. Alright. So, now, we need to set ourselves to a task. So let's look at our map. Now, we have a relay beacon over here. Can we set a custom ping? Okay, so we're going to be going downward at any rate. So, do we... Okay, looks like our heat has worn off. We slaughtered that guy. He's dead now. It's all good. You know what? Let's go back over here and pick up this gear. Come on, guys. Just... Okay, that's going to fill up whoever's ammo it was who got there. I think it was a hacker who got there first. So, we're going to come over here. And... Wherever that was. Okay, it should be right there. Okay, they're going to find their way over here. There's no, there's no high-risk areas between here and there anyway. But... I don't understand. What is this building for? Noir. It's the Silhouette Porno Club? I don't know. Seems alright to me. What's this? Fear Dungeons? Club 3.93? The Hexaloid Experience? Limited Run. Okay. The Black Annex Club? Oh yeah, I see. There's gonna be some annexing going on. The Canto Cola... Man, I like the atmosphere in this game. It's pretty cool. We got sexy astronaut, I guess. Maybe a race car driver? Not sure. Man, there's all sorts of like cool futuristic cars driving around and shit. Everybody's very polite to pedestrians in this place. That's what I know. They fucking stop for you when you get in your way. Okay, let's activate this cloning beacon. Is that what it is? Cloning beacon? Relay beacon. Yeah, we're making some big moves on this episode, huh? New dossier, Dracogenics Guarding Station, and new dossier, City Surveillance Authority. Okay, well, we'll take a look at that when we actually, like, need to. I believe that's going to make some new stuff pop up on a map. Yeah, CSA is right beside us. It's, like, part of this massive think it's one arm of this giant military base right here. So it looks as though there's a clear. Did that clear the custom ping? I think that did. Okay, so there's another relay station just up the road here. Let's go get that, because it's another one that's, I think it's in, like. Let's see, we can zoom out our map a little bit. No, wait, it's right here somewhere? What is this? CCTV? There it is. Alright, so let's select everybody, click the penis button, get them all over there. And we'll just peruse the city a little bit more. Should probably snatch some more people up with my hacker. Or my, Here, go mindfuck that guy while everybody walks over there. Don't think there's any soldiers within reach. Let me zoom my map in a little bit more. Yeah, I don't think there's any soldiers that are going to be able to do anything. This homeless guy, supposed to have a good day. Alright, homeless dude, go to cloning. Now, see, I don't have to pay the extra money to figure out if they're any good. I can just steal a fuck ton of clones, and no one can stop me, really. I mean, I can just take over anyone's mind at my own discretion. Okay. Everybody go down there. Dracogenics military compound. So we're discovering new places and new targets as we wander around and do these. So I think that might be part of the idea of those. Holy shit, look at that. Whoa. New dossier, Wyvern Inc. Checkpoint credentials for industrial district. Okay. Skull Shark? Skull Shark? Yeah, Skull Shark. Neat. Okay, anybody watching this homeless guy? No? Well then, I'm going to steal your mind. Yoink. Hey, dude. Would steal his mind. Meow. That, I guess the game sound effect is probably better than mine. Whoa, wait, I want to steal her mind. Oh shit, that was a bad move. Man, I had no idea that that was going on. Everybody. Oh. What happened there? So I just surrendered, and then he basically just kind of like told me to fuck off, I guess. What was that? He was like, he made my guy get down on the ground, but I just kind of like, it worked out. Okay, now that we have a few beacons up and running, we can use them to fast travel around the map. Select a beacon and fast travel your agents to it from anywhere in the city. Oh, wait, how do I do that? So if I go to like this, I can click fast travel all, or I can click. Oh, okay. Fast travel all. That's cool. Good to know. So then I can go back up to the one I just recently captured right here and click fast travel all. Man, that is so much better than just spending my time trotting around. Okay, so those are definitely worth collecting up. I'm gonna continue up this street and get the rest of them, because I think we can get our researcher that's up the street here. So where's the next one? All right, yeah, let's go to this. And we'll have all of our fast travel locations set up anyway. What's this? Hardwire panel. Okay, so our success chances. I realized in the last one we can hold Alt and right click on things, but it comes with a. I guess they come with their own sets of danger, right? Oh, is this hacker level 1? It is too. Okay. No, no, put guns away. Whew, okay. We need our hacker to come over here. That's not our hacker. Yeah, hacker. Never mind, dude. Just, this is our hacker. There we go. We need to get some of these ATMs cracked open so we can get an income started up. That's pretty important, I would say. So, these guys can go ahead and activate this beacon. And then I'll be able to fast travel my hacker over there anyway. So, I'll send them towards the next beacon regardless. So, new dossier. Checkpoint credentials for grid district. Okay, I'm not sure what that is, and I'm not sure entirely that it matters right now. But let's send them to the next area. And let's. Wait, select hacker. Oh my god, that's my support guy. Where the fuck is my hacker? Did I have him the first time? I did too. Okay. So, he's gonna hack that. This guy's gonna get headed towards there. What do we got? This is the security authority here. What can we do there? There's something we can infiltrate there. But we'll have to take a look at that in a minute. Dude, don't just run on top of the cars. Are you a psycho? Hopefully there's no one watching my hacker, because I'm not. Okay, we siphoned the ATM. This one's going to give us 19 cents per second. So there we go. We have an income now. Let's just have a look at the map real quick. Does it show us where ATMs are? It does. Doesn't it? Maybe not. Maybe it doesn't show us where ATMs are. It does show us where the ATMs are that we have hacked, though, because I can see the little money icon there. So I have to keep an eye out. ATMs are green. Got to keep an eye out for those, because, like I say, getting ourselves an income is going to be a pretty big deal. Okay, do we got this turned on? Okay, let's get that cracked open. Ba-doop. Okay, we got another autosave there. Now, are there any ATMs around? There's CSA location there. ATMs? Any ATMs? Just looking around in the fog of war. Might be a little tough to see them, potentially, but that looks like it's one. That requires level 4 hacking, though, so we're not going to be able to crack into that one for a little while. There's the Magnum Gagnum. Oh my god, what a name. Awesome. I enjoy that highly. I mean, not the Magnum Gagnum specifically, but just that they chose that name. It's pretty funny. Alright. So, I think what we need to do... I can't believe how long this episode has gotten already. I'm getting really, like, absorbed into this game. I think what we'll do for this episode is just finish off our relay beacons. Beacons? What is wrong with my brain? Why did I have to say that like that? The relay bacon. Okay, but look, is there an easier way for me to get back there? Yes, I can go to this relay beacon. I almost said it again. I almost said relay bacon. Okay, so we fast travel everybody to there, and now they're there. Awesome. Okay, so I'm learning how to use this a little bit better. Let's send everybody over to there. I'm not sure how long a path that's going to be. Maybe I want to do the other one first. Also, let's take a quick look around and see if there's any ATMs in the direct vicinity. Because, like I say, getting that income up and running, it's going to allow us to get our research going. We already got $19, so not bad, I'd say. Some of the ATMs are going to be guarded by cameras and stuff like that too, so it's gonna take some work to get some of them. But if we look in the right areas, there's probably some freebies kicking around. Man, that is one pissed off android motherfucker right there. Look at her hair, man. It's like she just jammed a bunch of shit into her head. That's like, in the future, cell phone screens did not stop getting bigger, and you just fucking jack into your brain to keep your cell phone running. That's how it's gonna happen, you know? Oh, look, there's a handy dandy guy to snatch his brain. Hello, I am stealing your brain. Can you steal the brains a little faster? Oh, sweet, that's filling up everybody's ammo and stuff too, apparently. Okay, you, mind drone, go get cloned. Thank you. I gotta wait for my thing to come back. So he's gonna stay there and harvest that bum. And we're gonna move on to the next area. Okay, this one. Can I tell everybody to move there or not? I don't know if I can. No, I can't. I suppose we should probably go across the street, though. So, did that move my map for me while I was doing that? Not sure if it does. Okay. So it said it was like just across the street somewhere. I would say it's, yeah, there it is. It's right there. So let's send everybody else there. And in the meantime, a hacker is going to hack this guy's brain. And we're going to build up our supply of clones. You having a bad day, dude? Don't worry. Now you won't know nothing. Okay, so... sent off for cloning. Carrie Schmidt, welcome to the team. You didn't have any choice, but still, welcome to the team nonetheless. Yeah, I hope you're a valuable asset. Ooh, what's this? Hacker level required 1. Okay, so we need to go check that out. But, oh, is this gonna control? I wonder if that shuts down that camera. I'm gonna try it out. If nothing else, it's gonna give our hackers some much needed experience. So let's check that out. Now, is that gonna shut down that camera? That camera is off. Hacker, go. Alright, so now we just gotta watch out for soldiers and stuff. But if there's no. Oh crap, there are some soldiers around. I'm gonna hope that they're gonna go around the other way at least. So let's go to these guys. I like how you can get a lot done if you're paying attention on this. So incidentally, I don't get a lot done a lot of the time. But oh wow, look at all the police cars around. This should be a simple hack though, right? Okay, so I think while he's doing that, yep, we've activated that. So let's skip back to him. All right, another ATM siphon installed. This one is 19 cents per second. So now we're up to what, 38 cents per second? Is that right? 15, 4, 4. Yeah, 38 cents per second. So that'll start to get our money rolling in rather smoothly, I would say. Let's go over to the rest of the team. And let's use our fast travel mechanic to get the team all in one spot. Alright. Fast travel all. There we go. Everybody's in one spot. Let's open up our map and let's collect this. I think that's the last relay in this zone. It is, too. So we're going to be going straight up from where we are. To. Wait, how far did I just go? I feel like I went too far. I gotta zoom my map out a little bit. Oh wow, look. That's. Is this the bank? I think that might be the bank. Either way, there's two ATMs there. But our fast travel spot, or our relay, is right there. So let's get over there. Let's get the relay. I think that's probably where we're gonna wrap it up for this one. But let's try to get it done in time. What does this do exactly? Let's hit the world scan real quick. What's that connected to? Okay, so that like manually shuts down some of the things in the area. Does it? Power routers can be found throughout the city and are used to redirect and restrict power to different areas of the grid. Power routers are considered to be an important infrastructure element and will usually be repaired quickly by if the router becomes inoperable. Huh. So I can. It's got a health limit to it. And it seemed to be linked to that gate as well as some other equipment around. I'll have to try destroying those at some point. Make sure I give, I'll. You know, make sure some near useless clone is attached to one of my guys, and then kind of sacrifice him to it. Man, doesn't this look like some kind of fucked up Pepsi symbol? That's the future of Pepsi right there. It's just gonna get all whacked out. They're gonna turn the symbol sideways. That is, it's like some crazy. This is like some crazy North Korean knockoff brand or Chinese brand. All right, fellas, let's activate that, and that'll be our last relay point. Feels good. I didn't know. I wasn't sure how much we could get done in one episode. We're running a little bit long, but I mean, I'd like to at least accomplish something in each episode. All right, mission log, relay beacon count. We have as wide a coverage as we need here now. Good work, team. All right, dismiss. I'm a little sad we don't get any bonus for that, but I mean, there is the bonus inherent in being able to fast travel. So, with that, that's gonna do it for this episode of Satellite Rain. If you enjoyed this, let me know. Leave me a comment or a like. Just you know, what you know. If you've got some hints or tips for me, I appreciate it. Keep away from the spoilers, but I do enjoy hints and tips. And this is Game Hoard Game. I'm Poob. Have yourselves a good one.